ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Scott County High School for the 2016 Royal Spring Middle School graduation ceremony. Would you please stand in honor of our graduates as they process in?
Thank you.
give a big round of applause for him. Would you please remain standing and remove hats and anything else from your head as Mr. Kevin Bowling, our band director, plays our national anthem. You may be seated. Welcome to Royal Spring 2016 graduation. We want this to be a great night of celebration for everyone in the room. This is a wonderful rite of passage that we celebrate these young men and women who sit before me today. I would ask that you please take this time to silence your cell phone. I'm waiting. What a joy to be in a place where we all fit. Thank you for being flexible with us as we have moved the graduation to a new location. There's nobody waiting outside the doors for the choir to get finished so they can come and sit on the risers because there's no room. This is a wonderful space to celebrate and have plenty of space. We'd like to thank Joe Pat Covington, DT Wells, Mr. Brent Merritt for allowing us to use this space, Mr. Greg Stepp for allowing the use of his instruments here. We would like to thank the ECS administration for the use of their stage. We'd like to thank Dwayne Ellison and Mr. Terry Neal for their help in setting all of this up. But most of all tonight, graduates, we want to thank you. Thank you for persevering. Thank you for your excellence and the tradition that you are leaving at Royal Spring Middle School. We wish to celebrate that tonight. Before I move forward, there are some special recognitions that we need to make. We have four former Grand Titans who are graduating from Scott County High School this year who have baccalaureate tonight, some of them, and so we've moved this to the beginning of the program. Part of the Grand Titan program, there is an expectation for outstanding academics as well as great character and perseverance. The Grand Titan Award is voted on by the Titan faculty. We will present some Grand Titan Awards to some of our students that are currently sitting in these seats in just a few minutes. But part of the Grand Titan Award is a $250 scholarship for those that have gone on and completed high school and prepared to go to college. And so we would like to present the 2012 Grand Titans with their checks tonight. So I would like to introduce you to them. Would you guys please come on up and join me on the stage? If you wouldn't mind to step forward while I'm speaking about you so that the folks know who that I'm talking of. First, I would like to introduce Miss Christina Holt. She is a valedictorian this year at Scott County High School. She is the senior class treasurer. Christina has been a part of the Governor's School for the Arts program. She plans to attend BYU on scholarship, where she will study psychology and music to prepare for a career in music therapy. Ladies and gentlemen, please applaud Miss Christina Holt. Next, I would like to talk about Brad Woody. Brad is also a valedictorian at Scott County High School this year. He has given back to RSMS by being a volunteer soccer coach during his time as a high school student. He plans on attending Duke University, where he will study neuroscience. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Brad Woody. Savannah Lambert is also a valedictorian at Scott County High School this year. She is also an alum of the Governor's School for the Arts and was a national merit finalist. She plans to attend Transylvania University but has delayed her enrollment so she can live and study abroad in Germany next year as the recipient of the Congress of Bundestag Exchange Scholarship through the U.S. Department of the State. Ladies and gentlemen, Ms. Savannah Lambert. And Mr. Chase Ritchie, who is also a valedictorian at Scott County High School this year. He plans to attend the University of Kentucky, where he will study engineering. He was the recipient of the Presidential Scholarship and the Lester Engineering Scholarship. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Chase Ritchie. Make your way to your seats so that you may perform the final countdown for us. Thank you.
Thank you, band. You may return to your seats. While they are filing back to their seats, I will ask Miss Emma Spencer to come to the stage. Emma is our Beta Club president, and she has prepared a few words for us tonight. Emma, thank you very much for being willing to speak to us tonight. We look forward to your inspiration.
Thank you all so much for allowing me to speak to you today and for an incredible 3 years here at Royal Spring Middle School. It seems like just last week, we were all walking into this school as terrified sixth graders ready to start the next chapter of our education. Since then, there have been numerous accomplishments and memories that will never leave us. The class of 2020 is so diverse and well-rounded, and yet it is not our individual achievements that will define us, but rather our unity and ability to work with one another. Since our sixth grade year, we have had many exceptional accomplishments in the areas of academics, sports, and the arts. We raised our math scores and had many students take the ACT last year, with several subsequently qualifying for the Duke-Tip summer program. The academic team had a very successful season this year and had one person place at the state competition. There was an abundance of eighth graders who performed well in the National History Day competition, both in their seventh and eighth grade years. This year was the first year in Royal Spring history that a student qualified for the national competition, and we had not one, but five students advance. The Vex Robotics team qualified to compete in the world competition this year after a successful season. Not only did we excel in academics, but we also showed time and pride through various athletics. Just this year, the boys soccer team won the conference championship, and the girls soccer team came in second. After the conference meet, the track team had many athletes advance in the state competition. Over the past 3 years, we've had an abundance of students go to All-State Chorus and Band, as well as ACDA, American Choral Directors Association. This year, both the 8th grade band and chorus earned a distinguished rating at festival. These feats are only a glimpse into the success of our class, and I know there will be more to come. In essence, our class is full of Renaissance men and women who, despite our diversity, have remained extremely close to one another. As the class of 2020, we must enter the next 4 years of our lives as confident and enthusiastic students, ready to take on all challenges. As E.E. Cummings once said, it takes courage to grow up and become who you really are. In closing, I would encourage you to have the fortitude to fulfill your potential and meet the needs of your community and world. As you do this, remember, once a Titan, always a Titan.
Thank you, Emma. We appreciate your words, and we appreciate the way that you delivered them to us tonight. What a great role model. If you are a member of the RSMS chorus, would you please make your way over to the risers? I had the honor of attending 6th, 7th, and 8th grade chorus concerts that happened last night. And what an amazing, talented group of young people we have here. They sang Hello better than Adele, and they sang Bohemian Rhapsody every bit as good as Fat Freddie did, I'm telling you right now. Ladies and gentlemen, the RSMS chorus.
Good evening. Ms. Mills and I now have the distinct privilege to present the 2016 Grand Titan Awards. We're very excited about these awards because the entire staff and faculty of Royal Spring Middle School had the opportunity to vote for the 8th grade students out of this class who exemplify the highest ideals in academics, character, school spirit, and leadership skills. This was a difficult choice for our faculty and staff because this graduating class is overflowing with deserving students. This year, two students from the transformation community and two students from the innovation community were chosen. The winners are undeniably students who have consistently, day in and day out, made outstanding grades, have been models of integrity, have proven leadership skills, and who personify the Titan spirit. We honor eighth graders in this special way so that our younger students will clearly understand how thankful we are when young people set such high standards for themselves. These students' names will be engraved on a plaque that is in our main hall of our school so students and visitors alike can see how Royal Spring honors those who achieve at the highest levels. Each student will receive their own plaque as a special reminder that we consider them Grand Titans, and as you saw earlier this evening, we hope that they'll come back in 4 years and receive a scholarship. Ms. Mills will now present the Grand Titans for the Transformation Committee.
Good evening. The first Grand Titan I would like to present is described as selfless and kind by those who know her best. She often anticipates the needs of others before they even know their needs themselves. She has a passion for serving others. Since sixth grade, she has been involved in choir, Girls on the Run, Beta Club, and Leadership League. Outside of school, she is active in her youth group at Grace Christian Church. Additionally, she enjoys taking pictures of her family and friends. In the future, she dreams of becoming certified as a social studies educator and returning to teach at Royal Spring. This phenomenal young lady believes in the positive influence of others. She finds heroes for herself and unexpected people, and she is a quiet hero to so many students and teachers on our hallway. In her In This I Believe speech, she writes, Proverbs 29:18 states, where there is no vision, the people perish. In essence, the meaning of this epigram mirrors leadership. If people don't have guidance, they will fall. Life brings disappointment, sadness, and suffering. But there are people who help guide you. Those people are your heroes. This young lady is certainly a hero to us at Royal Spring, and she will be dearly missed as she moves on to high school. Please celebrate with me as we honor Kylie Jo Curtis of the Grand Titan. Please celebrate with me as we honor Michael France.
And now for the Innovation Community Grand Titan Awards. The young man to receive this award is first and foremost a gentleman. With a slight bow and a wit-laced grin, he listens well and seeks consensus. He is passionate about learning, always digging for genius points and diving deep into the realm of the metaphysical. The quote, "A rising tide lifts all boats," is appropriate for him because his presence in class or in any group activity lifts the attitude, the learning curve, and the character of the entire group. His algebraic explanations and his dictionary explications render the class speechless. This young man also has the unique ability for being able to question the credibility of a teacher's answer or theory without showing disrespect. He simply raises his hand and says politely, Mrs. Hemrick, I think the dictionary says that the word more precisely means. He's always looking for that loophole of some sort of fact that he believes he can disprove, and by engaging in lively discussion and debate, this young man has grown tremendously in his analytical thought, a complex step in a scientific method. His list of accomplishments at RSMS include gold cards for all A excellence while taking the most rigorous courses we offer, Leadership League, Beta Club, Academic Team First Place Math Awards, playing on the Scott County High School tennis team, 3 years with the RSMS VEX Robotics team. This student was one of three teams crowned champions at the VEX Robotics State Championship, and he later competed at the world competition and finished ranked 64th in the world. Teachers say of this scholar, he's one of those students every teacher loves, he's hardworking, always respectful, and will continue to ask insightful questions until he gets the answer. This student accepts setbacks as a slingshot that will propel him to go and achieve more. In fact, in his This I Believe speech, he said, "No one in life became successful without making mistakes and experiencing failure. Failures may include suffering at first, but as Mother Teresa said, suffering is a gift from God. And as Emerson said, the greatest glory lies not in never failing, but in rising every time we fall." I look for this young man's touch to help redeem this earth. Congratulations to Grand Titan 2016, Mr. Hayate Takeda. This young next scholar. She's a front row, spunky, titan, tenacious, competitive person, and mostly competitive with herself. When this young scholar sets out to complete an assignment, she strives for perfection. She sets the bar high, but then in a compassionate, welcoming way, she lifts those around her to higher ground as well. Her list of accomplishments include making All-State choir numerous times, Academic Team State Governor's Cup participant in the Arts and Humanities, Beta Club President, Leadership League, Yearbook, Anti-Bullying Club, and All-A Gold Card recipient every year taking the most rigorous course load we offer. For the National History Day State Finals competition, this young lady was selected as one of two middle school students to represent Kentucky at the national finals in Washington, D.C. in June. She will not be able to take her place at those finals, however, because she will be in Guatemala completing a mission trip with her church, indicative of her compassion and God-breathed spirit. Hemingway said that the best among us are able to show grace under pressure, and this student handles every challenge with one eye focused on social justice causes and the other eye set towards acceptance and understanding of those different from herself. She enjoys sharing discoveries with others, has the ability to talk with adults better than most. She is the personification of servant leader. One teacher said of her, this student doesn't wait to see the vagaries of the crowd before finding out her own perspective or taking her own path. She does her own research listens to the opposing side, and then charts her own course to the stars. In her This I Believe speech, this young lady said, if one looks the right way, the whole world is a garden. But if we look the wrong way, the world is a desert. Perspective can be the threshold between pessimism and optimism, jubilation and depression. We must find perspective in times of difficulty, and if we do, our futures will be bright with fulfillment. I look for this young lady to be God's next best chance to help redeem this earth. Congratulations to Grand Titan 2016, Ms. Emma Spencer.
Could we have one more round of applause for all of our Grand Titans? And now Mr. Brent Allen will present our faculty Grand Titan. This evening, while we take the opportunity to honor the excellence and the accomplishment and all the work that has been put in by this 8th grade class, we would be remiss if we did not take the opportunity to highlight the excellence and the opportunity that was poured into them by the staff that we have before us. So let's give a hand to all of those staff members that have contributed so much. It was once said that leadership is not a sometimes thing, it's an all the time thing. I would even take it one step further and say that excellence is not a sometime thing, it's an all the time thing. True Titan excellence, as demanded by our staff, is the work ethic, the character, the virtue, and the dedication to make each and every one of our students the best that they can be. We have so many faculty that we can say legions of wonderful things about, but this evening I want to highlight one specific individual. When I had the pleasure of talking to some of the peers of this individual, some of the things that were brought out to me were their constancy. They were committed. They were there with their peers in the emotional highs and lows. They were there in the professional and the personal concerns. They were always there to cast an encouraging word in support of their peers. They always gave sound advice. Her peers know that they can come to her looking for leadership, integrity, and strength. A couple of other things that came were the quiet nature that this individual has, the calming soul that she is, and how she provides a foundation to all those around her. She would do anything for anyone, and she has a heart of pure gold. Ladies and gentlemen, I am so pleased to be able to highlight this individual tonight. I think the quote, "the best teachers teach from the heart, not from the book," very much describes this individual, because it is a commitment of a lifetime. They don't do it for the money, they don't do it for the accolades, they don't do it for the praise, and this individual would probably be embarrassed that I'm about to mention her, but Paula Sennett has gone above and beyond for our students over the years. She is a leader in her content, she is a leader in her community, and she makes our entire school better. So please give her a round of applause.
Shannon Gullett built. But let it now be said that this is the house that Keith Greiser has anointed with his own wise and charismatic finishing touches. I was on the committee that recommended Mr. Greiser to be RSMS principal, and I will never forget the 90-minute impromptu phone interview he gave while on the deck of the Disney cruise ship about to set sail. His professionalism, practical experience, and passion for kids and learning brought him to the helm of this ship, and he has set his sails full speed ahead. His strong faith foundation allows integrity to guide his decisions, and his ability to relate to and positively impact all students has allowed him to be a catalyst for change, as well as a person who keeps us standing firm on the bedrock principles of the Royal Spring Middle School way. Mr. Greiser holds a Bachelor of Music Education and Master of Arts in Education from Georgetown College. He earned his rank one in school administration from Moorhead. He has an eclectic resume, including assistant basketball coach at Georgetown College, music teacher at Stamping Ground Elementary School, Scott County gifted education teacher, an at-risk student advocate and varsity basketball coach at Montgomery High School, and most recently, Dean of Students here at RSMS and now our esteemed principal. A few fun facts about Mr. Greiser. Upon marrying his college sweetheart, Amy Elvin Greiser, they moved back into his fraternity house to be dorm parents for 3 years while she attended pharmacy school. While coaching at Georgetown College, his team won the NAIA National Championship in 1998, and his team won the KHSAA Sweet 16 while he was an assistant coach with Scott County in 2003. He's also a graduate of UK Next Generation Leadership Program, and he's an accomplished singer. And he has 4 children, Emily, age 16, Luke, 9, Grant, age 6, and Adam, age 5. My favorite theologian, Frederick Buechner, once said, when finding your calling in life, you want to find that place where your own deep gladness meets the world's deep hunger. And that is the place where you will find your worthy vocation. Well, Mr. Greiser, it's apparent that being principal here makes you deeply glad. And the students and faculty certainly have a deep need for your considerable gifts. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Keith Greiser.
Thank you, Ms. Hamrick. It's kind of backwards, right? Like when the person that should be giving the speech introduces you, that's kind of messed up. But I appreciate the kind words, Ms. Hamrick. Faculty, staff, parents, distinguished guests, and most importantly, graduates of Royal Spring Middle School, class of 2016, I am so proud to be your principal. And it is an honor to speak to you on this beautiful evening. Today is a special day for you graduates, for your proud parents, your grandparents, friends, and for your completely exhausted teachers. They're proud of you too. You have made your mark on Royal Spring. You have carried the torch of excellence, and we, the faculty and staff, thank you so very much. The class of 2016 has a wonderful personality that combines rigor and fun, and I love that. Did you know that you are the last class to come through RSMS with true open enrollment? I remember a couple of your dads camping outside the door next to the gym the night before open enrollment began so that they could be first in line on the day to fill out the open enrollment papers. Back then, it came in order of how you approached it. Your application was timed and dated. I believe it snowed that night. And in addition to the 3 or 4 that camped out, there were about 40 parents sitting in the parking lot by 4 o'clock in the morning that day. To quote the great theologian Coach Cal, you people are crazy. Gr- Graduates, there are people in this room who care about you more than you can imagine. They have high hopes for you and they believe in you. You are making them proud with all that you are doing. For some of you, those people are family, for some friends, and for others, it might be a teacher or a staff member who believed in you and did whatever it took to help you succeed. Look around this room. Make eye contact with your people. Did you see them? They were smiling and taking pictures and videos so that they can treasure this moment forever. Today is such an important day for you and for them. They are very, very proud of you, and I'm going to give you some advice. Today would be a great day to ask them for some money. It seems like just yesterday when you came to Royal Spring for the first time. Think back to transition camp. Do you remember the first day of school, your sixth grade year? You didn't even get a schedule that day. Do you remember trips to the creek? Do you remember reading Stormbreaker before you ever entered the doors at Royal Spring and then discussing it once you got here? Do you remember Australia Day? Now you walk down the hall and you see those sixth graders going to lunch and you think, man, those guys are tiny. But ask your parents. It wasn't that long ago that that was you. It has been so much fun to see you grow and how much you've learned and how much you have matured. Do you remember planting tulips to remember the promise of being drug-free? The This I Believe speeches that have been mentioned on multiple occasions already tonight. The trip to the Underground Railroad Museum, National History Day projects, Operation Preparation, Reality Score, Soccer Domination, Dissecting Frogs and Sharks, Oh My, Vex State Championships, Kings Island, and what about that day when Coach Simpson named the two strongest men in Royal Spring, Spencer and Tay? What great memories. Now here we are at eighth grade graduation. I would suggest that you embrace the moment. I also know that as I list some of this great stuff that has gone on, this was middle school. And I'm willing to bet that every single one of you struggled with something at some point during the last 3 years. In reality, a bit of struggle is a good thing. Our goal is that you learn to struggle now, while your grades matter very little. Yeah, that's right, I'm your principal and I said it. Your grades in middle school mattered very little. Starting next year, you'll have a GPA that matters a lot. But none of your middle school grades are factored into that GPA. You have a clean slate. Each one of you has a clean slate starting next year. Colleges that you will want to attend will look at that GPA. Your keys money is tied to that GPA. And my hope as your principal is that we made you struggle now and that we taught you how to get through those struggles and find success on the other side. You probably didn't like it at the time. But now you can look at the teachers at Royal Spring and say thanks. Because you're going to be able to look at the teachers at the high school and think. Now, I did say think. Don't say this. Just think this. Bring it on. I've got this. I'm prepared. I am a scholar. I am a titan. So bring it on. I'm ready. And you are ready. We have prepared you. And you have prepared yourself. I'm going to take just a second and ask a favor. Stop texting your friend about how you wish Mr. Greiser would shut up so that you could get off to the dance to show off your newest dance moves and then off to Waffle House or Steak and Shake or B-Dubs or whatever it might be. I'm on the downhill slope. But I want you to know something. You're not the only one who has struggled. I talk about all this great stuff that has happened this year and over the last 3 years, and then yet there have been so many days when I personally have felt the struggle. Days when I felt like a complete loser because as a first-year principal, I made some mistakes. I hate making mistakes. I take it hard. I get down on myself, I get angry, I get frustrated, I even sometimes doubt my own abilities. I struggle. But I swear, every single time I got into that struggling mindset, I would get a text or an email from one of your teachers, and it would say, hey, come to my room today. We're doing this great activity that you have to see. And I would go, and I would watch you, graduates of 2016. I would interact with you, and you would teach me about what you were learning, and you would inspire me. Class of 2016, you raised me up. I'm stronger when I'm on your shoulders, because you raised me up to more than I can be.
You raise me up so I
thank you for your time and attention, and congratulations on a job well done in class of 2016. We will now present the diplomas and pins. As we get organized for this portion, I would like to make a few requests. We have a lot of names to call tonight, and we want each of you parents to be able to hear the name of your child. So we are going to request that you refrain from applause until we have announced all of the graduates, and then we'll go bonkers together. But if you wouldn't mind, we'll call the names, they will come up and shake my hand, and we'll call the next name in pretty rapid succession so that we're not here all night long, and so that you can hear the name of your child being called. So if you would refrain from your applause until the end, that would be much appreciated. Thank you very much.
Tyler Abney. Daniel Adams. Haley Addington. Jacob Atkins. Kristen Bailey. Lindsay Barber. Star Barber. Eli Clay. Jillian Barnes. J.B. Berea. Isaac Baco. Dustin Burnett. Jacob Kane. Grant Cameron. Bryce Carpenter. Bryson Coretti. Jacob Coretti. Taylor Carwell. Mariana Castillo. Alicia Coggle. Corey Coggle. Donald Chambers. Kylie Jo Curtis. Cameron Darnell. Alex DuBois. Alyssa Devers. Adrian Diaz. Madison Duke. Philip Duncan. Abigail Dutra. Cable Eddington. Gracie Elin. Devin Enfield. Logan Farley.
Julius Ferguson. Michael Field. Haley Finch. Shane Fletcher. Alexia Flora. Megan Fox. Macy France. Melissa France. Michael France.
Rachel French. Kayla Fryman. Grace Gardner. Samuel Garrison. Hallie Gibson. Jasmine Giddings. Dalton Giles. Ashante Gibbons. Kirsten Glass. Courtney Glass. Miranda Getz.
Michaela Goff. Reagan Golden. Marisol Gomez. Caden Graham. Kenna Green. Garrett Greenfield. Daniel Greenwell. Ellery Hathaway. Andrew Hall. Morgan Hambrick. Teme Hampapuro. Tepan Hampapuro.
Emily Hampton. Spencer Hansen. Cheney Harris. Dontarius Harris. Jillian Harris. Destiny Haynes. Tristan Haynes. Callie Haywood. Bryce Hearn. Madison Heck. Omar Height. Jordan Hill. Caleb Johnson. Kaufman Johnson. Braden Johnson. Maya Justice. CJ Jones. Samuel Jones. Raja Jones. Cody Carr. Maya Cash. Caleb Keller. Daniel Coons. McKenna Lambert.
Gage Looney. Maxwell Lowry. Madison Lumpkin. Lauren Lesby. Dylan Madden. Alexander Malone. Diana Marquez.
Jacob Martinez. Jaylee Mason. Devin Maddox. Kalia McCoy. Ikeria McCray. Ariana McCurry. Gab McComb. Mike McKenzie. Nate McKenzie. Casey McLean. Sandra Dez.
Riley Meredith. David Mills. Jenna Moss. Caitlin Mullen. William Mullen. Lane Malloy. Tay Naley. Haley Napier. Jamacia Neal. Roy Mee. Shelby Noelcher. Kirsten Norris.
Janet Ojeda. Carly Opelt. Colin Opelt. Glenita Ortiz. Rosa Ortiz. Sage Osborne. Emily Parker. John Payne. Brady Penn. Amon. James Phillips.
Aubrey Pittman. Alexandra Paul No. Callaway Porter. Abigail Preston. Celeste Raglan. Dylan Ray. Savannah Reeves. Skylar Reeves. Isabella Reich. Trevor Renfro. Laura Rich. Lydia Rimey.
Taylor Roach. Kimberly Roberts. Amelia Robinson. Tiffany Seat. Devin Sell. Avin Sexton. Haley Sexton. Donovan Shackelford. Isaiah Shannon. Emma Spencer. Emmy Spore.
Justin Skelton. Kalena Slaughter. Sarah Sloan. Messiah Smith. Mallory Smith. Valerie Smith. William Smith. Jalen Soto. Lily Southworth. Abby Sparks.
Tay Stamatis. Lakin Stephan. Makaya Stevens. Allison Sturgill. Isaac Sullivan. Alyssa Sword. Lindsay Tackett. Ayate Takeda. Caitlin Taylor. Peyton. Kate Walker. Bethany Wells. Sierra West. Hunter Westenhofer. Dion White. Nicholas White. David Whittington. Lindsay Whitick.
Caitlin Williamson. Grace Wilson. Michaela Wilson. Nicholas Wilson. Stephanie Wright. Pariah Young. Mason Sandy.
I'm just thinking about
so much. Parents, you can meet your graduates out in the foyer. The dance lasts until 9:30. Please come get them at 9:30. We would love to get them back to you at 9:30. And we'll celebrate all night long. Thank you so much.